either, as you'll see why in the quarterfinals against Slovakia, Team Canada beat 3-2 in the preliminary round. Well, in this game, just under 6 minutes into the first, it is Branko Radivojevic shooting, and Thomas Kopecky gets a stick on it, so it's 1-0 Slovakia. And just over 3 minutes later, Miro Chetan knocks down the puck in the slot and beats Cam Ward 2-0 Slovaks. Late in the period, Canada coming back, Ryan Getzlaf puts it on goal, goes off a few legs, and in. Evander Kane gets credit for that goal, a 2-1 game after one. Go to the second period now, and Canada is on the power play. Dion Phaneuf stretch pass to Jordan Eberle. He is stopped by Jan Latso. The puck comes to Jeff Skinner in front, and he buries it, and this game is all even at 2-2. And late in the period, Latso making one stop. Chris Russell puts the rebound towards the net. Alex Burrows taps in his third of the tournament, and Canada down 2-0 at one point, but leading now 3-2. Midway through the third, Thomas Tatar, the drop pass to Milan Bartovic, and he gets it by Ward to tie it up again. Under 5 minutes to go, Ryan Nugent-Hopkins gets two for boarding Bartovic. Canada does kill off that penalty, but then this seconds later, under 3 minutes to go, Getzlaf colliding with Juraj Mikus, who was down for a while before struggling to get off the ice. Getzlaf is given a five-minute major in game misconduct for kneeing. And on the next faceoff, Slovak power play, Michal Handzus tips in the shot, and Slovakia takes a 4-3 lead. Still with a man advantage, over a minute left. Canada pulling the goalie to make it a 5-on-5. Russell tees up Dion Phaneuf, but it hits a body in front. Slovakia hangs on to win 4-3, and Canada loses at the quarterfinal level of the World Hockey Championship for the third straight year. This was Slovakia's first win against Canada in seven tries, dating back to the 2002 World Championship when Slovakia won its first and only goal at the Worlds. John Liu has more from Helsinki.
Canadian captain Ryan Getzlaf took a five-minute major for kneeing Juraj Mikus and was ejected with 2.5 minutes left in regulation. 4 seconds later, the Slovaks used the ensuing power play to their advantage to author the upset of the tournament.
It's a shitty way to lose. It's not what we came here for, and not what I came here for. Unfortunate incident.
I don't think it was a dirty hit. I thought he was finishing the check. I didn't know if he stuck his leg out or not.
That hit back in the NHL might have been a different call, but we're over here. You got to deal with the refs over here, and they call it a different game.
Canada spotted Slovakia a two-goal lead before the first period was halfway through, but scored three straight times to carry the lead 6.5 minutes into the third. That was when Milan Bartovic and Slovakia were rewarded for their persistence.
You know, we were hanging around. I mean, that's what underdogs usually do, and if they win, that's what they do. They hang around. I know that in the second they had a lot of chances. You know, our goalie was great. And in the third, we said it's one goal game, it's a one shot.
It's a tough way to end the tournament, there's no question. You know, you play well as a team for 3 weeks, and things are in control, and just kind of gets away from you towards the end.
A one-goal lead against any team in this tournament isn't safe, and a lot of things are very unpredictable when we come over here and play in this tournament, especially when it's one game, sudden death.
Slovakia wins a quarterfinal game for the first time in 8 years and snaps a six-game losing streak to Canada that dated back to 2002. Meanwhile, Canada has now lost in the quarterfinals for a third straight year. John Liu, TSN, Helsinki.